Late last week, the White House announced that American special forces will be sent to Syria to join the rebel armies. While only 50 are being deployed so far, it marks the first time that there will be Western boots on the ground in this war. Canada is moving the other way. The Trudeau government will soon end our participation in the bombing campaign. But during the transition period between governments, the Canadian forces continue to attack targets. Just one day after Canadians elected a Liberal government, two CF-18s attacked an ISIS staging area, and there have been at least two other airstrikes since then. In a new book, Gwynne Dyer argues that this is the wrong approach. Don't Panic suggests that governments are overreacting and should try something completely different. And joining me now from Montreal is the author, Gwynne Dyer. Mr. Dyer, awfully good to have you here. You know, there was one line in the book that sort of summed up your thesis that really struck me, and I'm paraphrasing it a bit, but you said that, generally speaking, we should ignore terrorism because it's much smaller than we think, and that, frankly, sending troops to the Middle East is, in your words, just plain dumb. Yes. Why?
Actually, it was also, I think, President Obama's, but I didn't give him the line. Because we are not facing, as I think the outgoing Prime Minister said, an existential threat. We're not even, which means a threat to our existence, we're not even facing a big threat. I mean, you know, two Canadians have been killed by terrorists in the past 14 years since 9/11. Two. Last year, admittedly, so it's fairly fresh in our memories. But, you know, even counting the two other Canadians who got radicalized and were the terrorists, that's a bad car crash. Why would you write a law about that? You know? So, and certainly, why would you send troops? On the assumption, I suppose, you see, the Americans assume that the 9/11 attacks were about them. They're trying to bring us to our knees. They're trying to humiliate us. They hate our values. No, it's not like that at all. They did it to get the U.S. to invade a Muslim country. Terrorists have strategies. They're revolutionaries. They want to come to power. And in order to come to power, they need popular support. And since the ideology is a bit weird, it doesn't automatically come up, you know. So what do you want to do? You want to radicalize the population. What better way than to get the Americans to invade?
Well, on that point, though, Gwynne, because in the past you have often said that military intervention of any type is counterproductive, you take a slightly different position in this latest book on that, and you're saying that, in essence, and again I'm paraphrasing, that our position should be, at least in the short term, to support the regime of Bashar al-Assad.
Yes.
Why is that?
Well, because if he goes down, it is the Islamist extremists, the head choppers, who take power in all of Syria and are then on the borders of Israel and in, quite possibly, in charge of a good deal of Lebanon and Jordan as well as Syria, because they could go right over the, you know, there's millions of refugees fleeing Syria, and they just follow in the footsteps of the rebel, the rebels follow in their footsteps. I was up in the Bekaa Valley in Lebanon last month, which is right next to the Syrian border, and frankly, there's checkpoints on the road every 2 kilometers. They're scared that if Assad goes down, Syria falls into the terrorists' hands, and the next thing you know, they're here too.
So, in essence,
you don't want that to happen.
In essence, though, are you saying then that the Russians have got it right?
Of course they have.
And the Americans have got it wrong?
The Americans have got it wrong because they insist on believing that they can have two contradictory things, that they can fight ISIS and, as Mr. Obama said, degrade and ultimately defeat it. I don't know quite how he gets to the defeat bit. But at the same time, they can bring down Assad. Well, there are no major forces other than those people in Syria. I mean, there's ISIS, Islamic State, but there's also the other major rebel force against the regime. It's called the Nusra Front. It's actually a clone, a breakaway from ISIS. They have the same ideas, the same goals, and they make up 90% of the opposition fighters. So if Assad goes down, these guys win, which is what the Syrians, the Russians understood. And when it looked like Assad was going down last summer, they decided to go in.
But let's take a look then at how Western policy is devised. And as you and I have talked about in the past, sometimes it's because of what is seen on the 6 o'clock news, these horrible images of beheadings and throwing people off of buildings and so on. So what you're talking about is a strategic approach to the problem there. But then what about the moral dilemma, the moral obligation that the West feels to prevent this type of butchery that is going on?
Well, I mean, that's where we get to. This is not a strategic interest. It may be a moral interest of ours to intervene if you're willing to take the casualties and accept that you'll be killing some innocent people, because when bombs drop, innocent people die. But morally, you know, this could be justified. But you cannot justify it on the basis that they pose a threat to our survival or even our comfort and well-being, the terrorists. You have to be honest about it and say, well, we're okay. Whatever happens in Syria, it won't affect Nova Scotia much. And nevertheless, we are going to intervene because we think we can be helpful and there is a moral obligation. Well, the problem with that mainly is that we have intervened a few times, you know, Afghanistan, Iraq, Libya. Didn't work out all that well. So the track record's not encouraging.
Let me ask you a final question here. And as you know, we have a new government in this country, a government that has said that it is going to withdraw from the military, at least the bombing campaign in Syria and Iraq. We're going to stay on training troops. What's your advice to the new prime minister on this front? Is he doing the right thing or is he still too mixed up in it?
No, he's doing the right thing politically because, he's got virtually an open field to do what he wants. But if there's one Canadian plane shot down in Syria and they capture the pilot and they do what they did to that Jordanian pilot, that's the end of his honeymoon right there.
Okay. Gwynne Dyer, always good talking to you. Thanks very much for doing this.
You're welcome. Thank you.